Hello everybody, welcome to another how-to video with Shalom Mecca and Codaster. And today I will talk about linear transient dynamic analysis, which has been a request from one of our friends in our YouTube page. And there is a lot of material that I have prepared. We're going to see how we can load a time history ground motion, how we can do modal analysis of our structure and use these results then to do a dynamic analysis and to define modal dumping, and also how we can extract then some time histories of displacements, for example, and how we can visualize them also in Jupyter notebook, as I did last time. So let's get going. We have a lot of things to see. Here I have prepared a very simple structure. I'm going to provide not only the med file but also the HDF file that you can open in Salome. And it's a simple structure. I mean, I just created all the line elements, the faces. And in the end, I used the partition to glue everything together. So, for example, just let's say that if you have some geometries, for example, and you want to make sure that everything is glued, so, for example, in a concrete structure, you can use a partition after you have selected everything that you want. For example, in this case, I would do like this and partition. Then you would select face, for example, that is the element with a higher dimension. And then you have to click keep shapes of lower type, and that would give you a new structure with everything, let's say, connected, and then you go and you create your element, your groups inside. Anyway, this is what I did, and I have this building object, and let's see a little bit. I keep it a little bit simple. So we have the columns, have the beams, like this. We have the walls, we have the slab of the first story, the roof, and then we have some elements for at the base for the supports. This is a simple structure. Then I went to mesh and I used the And in order to mess it, let's see what I did. Edit. I used the quadrangle mapping in this case, so that I have the quadrangles and the local length of 250 millimeters. So all the dimensions are in millimeters. Have a 5,000 by 5,000 millimeters, 3,000 millimeters the height, and here we have a variable height of 3,000 and 5,000 millimeters. So this is our model, and then of course after the meshing we created groups from geometry and we transferred all the groups produced before. And this is our med file, which then we exported. Med file. And this is for the geometry in the med. Now let's go to the analysis file. Okay, there are two parts. I'm going to start with the first part very quickly. Okay, we have, of course, we read the mesh, we assign a model with, in this case, I use elements that have also shear deformation for cells and for beams. We have we assign the elements, of course, columns, beams, walls, same thickness. We have a single material we assign everywhere. Now here is the first comment. If you want this, if you want to have additional mass, for example, let's say that in the first slab, for example, I have some additional mass that can be non-structural component and also, for example, 30% of the viable load. The way I suggest that you do this is by modifying the density. So in this case, for example, we could create two more materials, that one would be for the roof, one would be for the slab, and we would calculate the equivalent density that we need so that we have the final mass. I'm not gonna do this because it's gonna be too long, but this is how I suggest that you can consider the correct masses models. Of course, then we have the support, and we have the weight, where I have the gravity, acceleration of gravity in millimeters. Now this is one useful command where we are requesting the masses. So here we are creating a table with the mass, and we can give him the groups that we want or all the structure, and then we are exporting, let's say, this mass in a table, in a file, in a resu file, and we are specifying that we want the mass and the center of gravity, the center of mass for each computed group. So this is one way to make sure that to verify what are your masses and calculate them you need. This can also be useful, for example, if you want to apply linear static forces, for example, seismic. In any case, then I use assemblage. And assemblage is used to assemble the stiffness and mass matrix. It can also be used for the damping matrix, but in this case, we're going to use the damping based on stiffness and the mass matrices. So this, with this command, we see here that we give him the support. So is already the final matrices for the stiffness. Stiffness can be inversed, and then we have to provide this concept. So everything that you see here in CO, that is the concept, is a name that we give. So we give a name for the stiffness matrix. In this case, I call it K-mat. A name for the mass matrix, M-mat, and this is the total number of degrees of freedom. Sometimes for some commands you may, in this case, just define it. As soon as we have this, we can go and we can calculate we can do a modal analysis. This is the simplest way, let's say, that I'm doing it. We define what is our stiffness matrix, what is our mass matrix. Then there are various options. You can always go and see the command. We are asking for the smallest, to start from the smallest frequency, so the highest period. And we are asking for 10 eigenmodes, 10 modes. For this case, I think that this was enough, as we have two stories, more or less. We can think about 10, but of course you can use whatever you want. And then I'm going to extract this information, some information about the modes. in a table, so you have to use imp resu here, not imp table, but the format is resulta, not med, and we have always the same unit number 10, and we are asking him the frequency and the effective masses in each direction. Then we are also exporting the deform the mode shapes essentially. And last but not least, we are doing also a static analysis of the weight. So the weight here was presented, so the gravity of my model. I'm doing a static analysis and we'll see where we will need this. And we are putting also this in our med file. And here, this is the first step of the analysis. So I can use fin, which means that it will, if I run this model, it will stop here. Now, as I did in my last videos, I'm using always ASTK. And in this case, we have the command file, the med file. Let's forget about this for now, because these are the time histories. And we're using result1.resu for the table information, and the result1.rmed for the mesh information. And if we run this, it will actually be pretty quick. You can see here that it is done, and let's go and see the resu file. So the resu file, we have all the masses. These are in should be in tons, if I'm not mistaken. The mass and the center of mass for each group, and for all the group. And here we have the information from the modal analysis. So these are the frequencies, so about 0.3 seconds going down, and the effective masses that you can effective masses that in this case, yes, you can compare with the total mass, so you have the percentage. So for example, here we have almost 90%, here we have 80%, and so on. So you can see also which are the important mode shapes. Of course, the torsion, be aware that the torsion here is not included, so you have to see the mode shapes. And let's go to actually do this. So I want to open result one Armed, and we have two results here. One is the mode shapes, the other is static. Let's see the mode shapes. Generate vectors, warp by vector. Okay. So this is the first mode shape. Of course, we expect that this direction is a weak one, because here we have a wall and there is also some torsion. The second mode shape is like this. And the third mode shape, that. We have the second form in the y direction, so second shape, second modal shape, so on. And then we have also some vertical modes. So the sixth mode shape is a vertical mode. This one is the vertical mode. This one is a... So these are the results of the modal analysis. And now let's go and continue our analysis with dynamic. So the dynamic part, I have here two time histories. They are from the P strong motion database, and this is an earthquake that happened in Italy in 1976. Friuli, the quite famous earthquake. And we have two components. I have created two columns. One is the time and the other is the acceleration in units of G. And we're going to use one for the X direction and the other for the Y. So we have both components in our model. Let's go first to see these results, to visualize them. I'm using a Jupyter notebook. So I use pandas and I read these txt files with delimited that is a tab. And we do like this. We can visualize the two components are around 0.3 g maximum acceleration, and these are the components that we're going to use. And let's go and see how we use them. So in SDK, I have to add a .dat file, and of course the units will depend on my command file. In this case, I'm using 30 and 31 for the two components, and you have to specify that is data and not a result. Then of course I also added the second resu file and a second armed file that we're going to see now what it's about, and with this you should be able to run analysis. So let's go back to our file. Now in this case I'm going to comment this, and let's go to see a little bit what I have done here in the beginning. So I have the acceleration of gravity, I have the time state that I want to do my analysis. So I remind you that is the time step of the earthquake file is 0.005, but I want to do my analysis on time step of 0.001. I am using a final time step to stop my analysis, but this can also be not be done. I mean, just something that I do so that I don't want to do all the analysis until the end. And I don't know, I see that for example 15 seconds looks okay. Have this variable, then I'm going to use a number for the to archive. So I'm saving one every 10 time steps, so I'm saving every 0.01 second, and I have also a dumping of 5%, and we'll see how we will use this. So we go back to our file. And the first thing we have to do is to define our time step. So our time step of the analysis, def list real. We start from zero. We have a time step of dt, and we are going to say until t fin. Now, in this case, we could also use, for example, I don't know, 35 seconds. That is the final time of our analysis. In any case, this can be done both ways. I'm just using now fin. And now there is the series of commands for its acceleration. So this is very important. First, we have to read the file. We said that I'm using a unit of 30, and the command is a lir function. So read the function. And we are specifying that the parameter is an instant, so it's a time, and the result is an acceleration. And then you have to give him indic para and indic resu as you see here. So what does this mean? Of course, you can always go to see the documentation. This means that the first number means that you have to consider, Codaster has to consider the first block of data. So the first block of data means that he's going to read here, and as soon as he, Codaster will find then the first block of number is going to consider that block. For example, a second block of numbers would be something like this. So here would be the second block. And from the first block, he will have to consider the first column, and then he will have to consider the second column for the result. So the first column is the parameter, the second column is the result of the function. Then, as we said, this is a function of the acceleration of gravity. We have to calculate a new function where we have the actual acceleration of gravity in the units. So we are using the comb calc function with comb and the coefficient of the acceleration of gravity. So this essentially is going to multiply our function that we just read by with this number. Another way could be to have a formula or something like this. Not there are various ways to do this, but in this case we can do it. And then the other part that is very important is that I'm going to interpolate this function now, so my final accelerations, I will have to interpolate with the time step. So this is very important because we have the acceleration file in whatever time steps there are. It could be also, for example, something written by hand, for example, 1 second, 0.1g in 3 seconds, minus 0.5g or whatever. You can also write your own acceleration, and then you have to interpolate it in the timestamp that you're going to do the analysis. So with this command, you have then the acceleration for each time step of your analysis. And of course, we're going to use linear interpolation, but can be also logarithmic for other cases, but not this case. And this essentially will give me the function of, let's consider it as a multiplication function of the acceleration. Now we have to define the force of the ground acceleration, and this is done with calcchar sisme. Essentially, we're going to tell him what is the direction that we want to apply a seismic force, what is the mass matrix, and if we have just one support. In this case, we say yes. There is also the possibility to have multiple supports. This is more complex, so we will not cover it. And if essentially then we create a load, so a fed char mecha, where we have a vector that essentially is a force equals to the mass for in this direction for the whole structure. So essentially we have this force and this function of force. Then we're going to do the same for the y direction, so unit 31, exactly the same things. And by that we have completed the seismic force we have to apply. Now I'm going to do something extra, which could also be avoided, but I just want to show it. Okay, I will explain it in a while. Let's forget about this now, and let's go to see now the command. So we have DynaVibra is the command. This is a general command where you can do linear dynamic analysis, harmonic analysis, and both on the whole model or on a modal base, so in a physical base or a modal base. There is also the command DynaLine that is more direct, but you can also see the documentation for that if you want. It will be similar, more or less, but I think that this is a more general command, and in the future we can also use it to do an analysis based on the mode shapes, which actually could make sense here, since we're doing a linear analysis, and especially, for example, you have a big model, you can use just the mode shapes to do your analysis much faster. In any case, let's see what we need for DynaVibra. We need the model, the element, of course, the characteristics of the elements and the material. Then we have the type of calculation is a transient as opposed to dynamic. And the base of calculation is the physical model as opposed to a modal base. Then we give him directly the stiffness matrix and the mass matrix. This actually means that we don't have to apply the support condition or whatever liaisons we may have. If we calculate these matrices, as we saw before, with the support already considered, as we saw here, then we don't have to reapply it in DynaVibra. If we calculate the modes without the support, of course we will have here to apply it. This is an initial state that is directly related to that, so for now we are not going to discuss it. Then we have the forces, and again I have here the weight. Now this, let's forget about this, okay, this will be addressed in a while. Here we have the sizing forces. So we have acceleration of force in X and the function. So acceleration F, acceleration interpolation, as you remember. So we have the force, the function we use twice. Then we have to define the modal damping, and one way is to do this with a more modal. There is also the possibility to use a Rayleigh damping, and in order to do that you will have to define the alpha and beta coefficients directly in your materials. This is a little bit more advanced, more complex. In any case, I think that this is, especially for linear analysis, this is fine. And what you can do here, you can specify how many modes you want to consider, and what is the damping. Here, for example, I have 5%. This means that for all these 5 modes, there is a 5% damping, nothing else. But for example, you could also have something like this, so you could have also different modal damping ratios for every mode shape. If this number is less, then it will take the last value and fill in for the number of mode shapes to specify. And here you have to tell him from what calculation of modes he will take the results. Okay, so doing it like that, and okay, let's go. We have then the increment, so we have the time step that we defined, and here I also show how we can stop the analysis before if we want. In this case, I'm using the final time tfin for everything, let's say. So even in this list, we were going up until that point, but just to show some flexibility. Then I'm going to say that I want to have this. I forgot. Okay. I want to keep one every 10 time steps. this is the archive step that I'm using. And in this case, I'm excluding the velocity result. In this, you have, in general, you have a depth, so displacement. You have the velocity, and you have the acceleration. So if you want to exclude some of this and save some storage or whatever, you can use it. So in this case, I'm going to exclude the velocity. And finally, you have to specify what is the see how you're going to calculate your dynamic analysis. In this case, I'm using the Newmark method. Nothing special here. There are also other possibilities, of course. And I'm using the constant acceleration scheme with 0.25 and 0.5 for beta and gamma. And with this, we have the dynamic analysis. Now, I want to talk a little bit about this. If you do this analysis and you don't specify the weight, you are going to get your results, but then, for example, you would need the displacement or the internal forces with the weight included. So somebody, I mean, you would want to include the weight as a force. If you don't consider this, so let's say that you just do your analysis and you apply also the weight, what will happen is that this weight is like a constant weight that is applied, let's say, as a dynamic load. So you're going to have a vertical vibration. How, there are various ways to overcome this. For example, one could consider a period, the beginning, where you have you are applying this weight with a function, a ramp function, where, for example, you can have also very high damping, so that when you arrive at this at the end of the first stage, you have applied the weight. The other way is to give it as an initial state. So that's what I'm doing here. And for a linear analysis, this is the best option, or possibly in general. So what I'm doing is that I am creating a new field that is the displacement from my linear static analysis. And then I am saying that the initial state will have this displacement. Now, since this is a dynamic analysis, you can also specify the velocity if you want, and even the acceleration. What is doing here, since the velocity is not given, is considered as zero, and the acceleration is calculated from equilibrium. So in this case, both acceleration and velocities will be zero, and I will have my initial state. If I have my initial state, I can also apply the force. So this means that my final displacement, my final internal forces, whatever I calculate, are taking into account also the gravity analysis. This can be handy, otherwise you would have to add these effects afterwards. And this now is the last part that I want to show. So let's say that Apart from that, we would like also to extract some information, even in table format. So I will extract the displacements of the roof in the x direction and the y direction. And I'm going to extract the average value of the roof. Of course, if you have you want a specific node, you can you know the node number, you can input here in instead of group ma, you will use node, or you can have a group of nodes or whatever. In this case, I'm just saying for the whole roof, give me the average displacement in x, and I'm going to call it displacement x. Then this will give you a table which has a lot of columns. Now, my goal is to have a table that I can use easily, let's say, for post-processing. So I'm going to use calc table, reuse this table that I defined, and I'm going to tell him that I want to extract the instant, and the moyenne will be the value that he extracted here. In this, of course, you have to do some tests to see what you get from this command and so on. So I'm extracting only this, and then I'm saying that I want to rename this to that. I'm doing the same for the y direction. And the last but not least, I am combining the first table with the second table based on the instant column. And this will essentially give me three columns. One is the instant and the displacement x, the displacement y. I'm going to import this in a table. And then I'm going to import also, which has a unit of 11, and I'm going to import the results, the dynamic results, in unit of 81. So by doing this, we have now the complete analysis, and we can click run. We will see here that is doing the analysis and is going to notify us the 5%, the 10%, and so on. I'm not going to do the analysis. I have already done the analysis. Let's go to see the results. For example, the resu file that I prepared is here. As you can see, I have every 0.01 seconds displacement in X, displacement in Y. I can also go to my Jupyter Lab. I can read the result to resu, and I can plot my time histories. So you will see we have about 20 millimeters displacement, the x and the y. And now let's go to our form shape. Let's see a little bit what we have. Second result, result 2. Generate vector, have acceleration and displacements. Let's see, based on the displacement, the form shape, to use 100, and here okay, let's see the vector. So before that was about 20. Okay, and this could be something like that. Now, the first thing I want to show is, of course, deform shape. You see that we have a deform shape from the first time step. Click play. Let's see. We can see, of course, the torsional behavior. And this is more or less the results. I suggest what you can also do if you want to play around a little bit. For example, you can comment this and try to see what you get. You can also comment this. If you comment this, everything will be okay. I mean, you will not have the weight. But if you leave it like this, it is interesting because I also tried it. And as I said, you have an initial vibration vertical. And due to the fact that I am using only the first five modes for the modal damping, that there is no vertical displacement for these mode shapes, you will actually see that this vertical vibration does not reduce. So you have for all your analysis, you have a vertical. This will be interesting for you to see. Then maybe you can increase this. For example, you can consider all 10 and see the difference. And play around a little bit with the various options. You can also extract, apart from the displacement, for example, the acceleration. But be aware that this acceleration is a relative acceleration. If you are looking for the absolute acceleration, you will have to add the acceleration of the ground. This depends how you want to do it. I mean, if you want to extract it on a table, can be easier. Otherwise, you will have to create a new field where you add the acceleration of gravity as a value, uniform value. This is that's all. I hope this can be an interesting video. For sure, it was interesting preparing it. Everything will be, of course, in our GitHub repository. And I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for your attention. Have a good day.